Good morning, Titans. I wanted to tell you about a big event coming up on January the 24th. It'll be Battle of the Bone night, and it'll be over at CV this year. But boy, do we have a great theme for you this year. We thought about this. We come up with a great idea. It's going to be an Infinity Bone. And if you take a look at the front side of the T-shirt, it'll look like this. It's got Thor, and he's got a bone in his hand. It's got electricity coming off to the bone, and it's hitting that bear right in the head with it. So I think that's going to be a great front side. And the back side might even be better. We got the Guardians of the Bone on the back with all the characters. And we just think this is going to be an outstanding T-shirt. I got to tell you, this T-shirt, because of the great artwork we have and the color scheme, it's a quality shirt. So it's going to be $15 for a short sleeve and $20 for a long sleeve. But I can promise you, if you buy one of these, you'll wear it more than once. We'll start selling them on Thursday, the day after the Sneaky Sneaker game. We'll be in the cafeteria having people sign up, but I have to let them know how many T-shirts we're going to buy. So if you're thinking about it, buying one, let me know Thursday or Friday. Yeah, if you don't buy them by then, it'll be really hard. We'll sell whatever's left over, but we ran out last year. So be aware, great T-shirt, great event. Hope you can be there for the Battle of Bone, one of the greatest events you'll watch. Okay, thank you.
I'm here to tell you about the People of the World Club that happens after school every Monday in A205. We're here to celebrate different cultures, countries, and backgrounds, and our motto is to discover yourself, discover others, and stop ignorance. So why don't you stop on by, get some food, learn about other people's backgrounds and stories, and we're going to have a good time.
Hello, Titans. My name is Caleb Bulldozer, and I'm going to be interviewing kids and some teachers about the finals.
Yeah. How long has your classes been studying for the finals?
In reality, they should have been studying for finals since day one of the semester, so I guess all semester long.
Do you think your students are ready for the finals?
I think some of them are ready for the finals, and some of them probably not so much.
Okay. All right. Any advice you'd love to give to your students about finals?
You're going to want to definitely study up. And you gotta really get into those books and make sure that you're digging deep, making those flashcards, doing those Quizlets, doing that study session review, jam, cram, okay? And everything's gonna be great.
All right, last question. Are you a cat or dog person?
Don't vape.
Are you ready for the upcoming finals?
Not the calculus one, but everything else, yes.
So I'm taking that's the one you're most terrified of?
Yes.
Is there any advice you'd love to give the students to help them with their own finals?
I would say study hard, be confident in your answers, and don't lose too much sleep over it.
All right, last question. Are you a cat or dog person?
Dog, for sure.
Are there any finals that terrify you at all?
Math. Definitely math. Math has never really been my strong suit. It's always been something kind of that I, you know, go along with and kind of just wing it, especially during finals.
I feel the exact same way. Now, is there any advice you'd love to give some other students so they do go on their finals?
Especially for the freshmen, I know that finals can be kind of terrifying. My advice is just don't overthink it, don't overstress it. Just, you know, me personally, I like to have fun the day before finals. So that way, going into finals, I'm not as stressed. So that's really all the advice I have. Don't overstress it.
Awesome. So last question, are you a cat or dog person?
I'm a dog person. You know, I like having that, you know, kind of companionship between me and my pet, you know, cats that kind of just like, eh. Yeah.
I'm like a cat then. Okay. Thanks for your time. How long have your students been preparing for finals?
Well, so the very beginning of the semester, we started a technical unit. And so they've been studying it the whole entire time, and they just got the stuff that's going to be on the test, so they're starting now. Kind of cramming for it.
Do you think your students are ready for the finals?
I think they're ready for the finals. Yep.
If you were to give some advice to your students, what would you give them?
I would say don't have test anxiety. Try not to, because you guys are pretty prepared. It's just breathe, get a good night's sleep the night before, and believe that you can do it. I think you'll do it.
Last question. Are you a cat or dog person?
A dog.
Don't forget, Titans, that the finals are the 23rd through the 25th, okay? And do good and have fun.
All right, Titans, we need every single one of you out there Wednesday night. Come, please support us. We need every single one of you out the crowd to get those big points and defeat those Bears. We can't win without you guys. It has to be strength in numbers, so come and show up big. We want to see your Titan spirit. The game starts at 5, so if you're not taking the Rooter Bus, show up whatever time you feel like is appropriate. But if you are taking the Rooter Bus, the Rooter Bus leaves at 3:30 from here. It's $5 to get in, but if you have your GSL card, it's free. For anybody else, it's $10.
Hey, you guys coming to the Sneaky Sneaker?
Bruh, have you seen these AirPods?
I don't think so.
Take the Rooter Bus, it's free, but you gotta get on quickly because it fills up really fast.
And the game starts at 5, so you guys want to get there early to get a good seat.
Okay, let's go.